Are you finally ready to buy your own home? Did you know there are several things that could come up that could keep that from happening? There's a long list of things to get prepared so that you can make sure to have a smooth transaction and that you get to buy the home of your dreams. If that's you, stay tuned. This video, I'm gonna go over all the tips that you need to know before buying your home. Today, I want to tell you guys 5 things you need to do before you get ready to buy your home. So, you've been living wherever, renting, living with your parents, living with an ex, whatever you've been doing, and now you're ready to get your own place. Congrats, that's a huge step and that's awesome. So let's make sure you do these things so that you are ready to go and you can move in the direction you want to. Number one, know your credit score. So your credit score and your debt to income ratio are one of the hugest things that you need when it comes to getting a home. So that's going to affect the kind of loan you can get, what your interest is going to look like, all kinds of things. So if you have no clue what that is, then you're kind of already behind the game. You can go online, there's a couple of free websites that will tell you an estimation of what your credit score is. Now those are different than what the actual lender is going to use, but it gives you a general idea and that can give you some, you know, ideas of what you need to do, what you're looking for, time frame, things like that. So that's always the first step that I recommend. Number two, contact a local lender. Ding, ding, ding. I would love to help you guys. If I'm not local, there are other local realtors that would love to help you. Contact them and let them get you started on what you need to do. They can direct you on a couple of things, and they'll give you some of these steps, but a couple of things that you need to do so that you're prime and ready. They know the areas. You can tell them what you're looking for, and they can tell you, is this realistic? What do homes in this area go for? What are we looking like if we do this? Like, they can give you a lot of direction and help you make sure everything is in line. And that's such a crucial, crucial step. If you are going somewhere that you're not familiar with, why would you not want someone local to help you? I know when I go on vacation, I love to do local tours and get advice from them because they obviously know when's the best time to go here, where's the best place to eat. They can give me all kinds of information that's going to help and make my journey that much better. They're also going to be able to help you with number 3, which is get pre-approved. So important, gotta be done, and your local real estate agent can set you up with a couple of local lenders that can help you in this process. So I know it's really tempting to use some of those huge, big, nationally known lenders that are out there that are offering you all kinds of deals and whatnot. And that's fine if you want to use those. I have just personally seen really great results with local lenders because they're easy to get in touch with. They have the local appraisers that they use that we're really familiar with. It just makes for a really smooth transaction when you can communicate and get somebody every step of the way instead of having to go to an automated touch dial system that can't understand me because of my southern accent, which is not even there, really, y'all. But you know, it's just so much easier to go through and have somebody local that you can see and feel and touch and that they're there and they can help you through this. But that's going to be a huge step because you've got to get pre-approved. I know I've told you guys in some other videos before that without that pre-approval letter, your offer is just useless. I mean, really and truly, like, I have personally seen an offer that was better than other ones but didn't have a pre-approval letter and didn't even get considered. You've got to have it because that's the clout saying, yes, this person can buy what they're wanting over here. Yes, they are pre-approved for $250,000. So as long as this house is $250,000 or below, they're good to go. And this gives them that weight behind it saying that they're good. So that is a very, very crucial step we don't want to miss out on. Number 4, and this one really, like, you should have been doing a long, long time ago. It's fine if you need to do it now, but it's very important as well. Save up money. So people do not realize how much money it actually takes to purchase a home. Yeah, you see the home and it goes for $250,000, but there's a lot of other things that go into it that you may not be calculating and you need some extra money for. So if you were going to do an inspection, which I do recommend, that's going to cost you anywhere $300, $350. That's how much the typical guide that most of my people use. But it can be anywhere 300 or, you know, maybe up to 500 depending on who you get. But that's the person that's going to come in, inspect everything, let you know what's going on. I do have a video on inspections that I will show you guys at the end if you want to learn more about that process. But that's something important, well worth the money to make sure what you're buying is worth it. I've had several clients that put offers in on homes and then they found major red flags when they did the inspection and they went another way because they realized it was just going to be a money pit and it was not worth it. Also, you have to pay for the appraisal. I also did a video on appraisals that'll be at the end that you guys can check out explaining that process. But appraisals are typically around $500 or so. This is just really important because it's required if you're doing a loan. If you have a loan, unless there's a very specific situation where you do not have to do the appraisal, and you get it waived, you have to do it. And it just tells them how much your home is worth, but that's $500 you've got to come up with. And then also, depending on the kind of loan, now there are 0% down loans out there, but depending on the kind of loan, you may have a down payment that could be anywhere from 3% to even more of the purchase price down. And then you also have your closing costs. Now closing costs, you are responsible for. I have a closing cost calculator down there in the description. You can check that out, download it. You can plug in what the cost of the home is and it'll tell you what the closing costs are. But that is something you're responsible for. Unless you find a home where you can negotiate in for the seller to help you pay for closing costs, you're responsible for that. And that is going to be thousands of dollars looking at closing costs. So if you have down payment on top of it, that's another $1,000 plus the other money that I talked about earlier. So it's always a really good idea to have some money saved up that you have on hand that you can use to purchase this, be ready to go. And that's also really smart for once you buy a home. If you get a home warranty, which is a really good idea, that's gonna cover, you know, if anything happens, we need to do repairs, but it's also always smart to have a rainy day fund that you can tap into if you need to because something happened and you don't wanna be, you know, completely broke and not have any money to do it. And then number five, create a specific search. So this is going to be something great for you if you already have that local realtor helping you out. This is why it's important because we can set you up on a specific search so that you can get all the new properties that meet your description so you can see them first. This saves you from having to check the websites and MLS sites every day on your own. Now, granted, you're probably gonna do that anyways because most of us like to do that, but you've got an extra person right there who's sending you these properties and staying on top of it so that you don't miss out on anything that's coming up and you're ready to go. And it gives you an idea. I have done this for some of my clients and they have realized, okay, whoa, what I'm looking for at this price range, I'm just not gonna find anything I like. I'm gonna have to go back to the table. I'm gonna have to pay off some debt so that I can get approved for a little bit more money because these homes in this price range just aren't cutting it. And that's fine too, but it gives you that idea so that you know and you're not just sitting around wasting time not knowing what's going on. So if you guys faced any of these issues when it came to buying your home, if so, let me know in the comments. I wanna know, how was your experience? Do you have any advice that you can give people? Also, I have a couple other videos right here. Check those out just to kind of get you prepared with what the home buying process is. It's how we do appraisals, how we do inspections. Those will give you a ton of ideas to get you through the process and let you know what's going on. As always, thanks for tuning in, and I'm your unicorn agent turning your real estate dreams into a reality.